Hi, I'm Nikki Vershagen. Welcome back to the channel. We've got another retail video for you. And specifically with this video, we are going to take a look at a discussion with Edward Westenberg. So Edward is the retail lead for Europe from Sysco, and he has an extensive food retail background working both in corporate as well as consulting for many years. In his words, he would say his role is to connect your purpose to our platform and to help extract the value from the platform to help you reach your purpose as well as to help reach quota, which I think is really cool. The concept of utilizing IT along the process to help retailers really reach their purpose, that's neat. But in this conversation with Edward, we're specifically going to look at edge computing as well as why retailers are leveraging a multi-cloud environment. Take a look. Thank you, Edward, for coming to speak to us. We're here at NRF 2019, and we're going to be speaking a little bit today about multi-cloud, edge computing, all the great stuff for retailers.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Pleasure to be here.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So maybe first off, let's talk a little bit about retailers are obviously moving towards the cloud. They need to house their data there so they can help on scalability. So what are the reasons that retailers want to be moving towards a cloud, multi-cloud environment?
Absolutely. Well, it's obviously, it's clear that cloud will bring you speed, scale, and plenty of bandwidth for your applications, right? But the challenge, I think, for retailers really is that, so they've moved their application to the cloud, they've moved their data to the cloud, and these are often not necessarily the same clouds. So then control, visibility becomes a challenge. And I think that's why we want to make life easy for our customers. And so that's where multi-cloud is really the way to go. And we want to help our customers accelerate that journey to the cloud. And as we're talking about that, one of the things that I think is really important is, yes, you can move that quickly. You can have that visibility. You can have that control, that full control to make your life easy. But then at the same time, at the edge, which is where you deliver your brand experience, right, that's where your customers effectively touch your brand. So think about your mobile experience, think about your store experience, think about your help desk, your third-party logistics service providers. That's where you need to own your data. That's where you need to control your data. So you are in control of that experience, right? And I think that's really, really key. And I think that so as you design your digital strategy and as you move towards the cloud, you should not forget about the edge, because there needs to be this balance going forward, right?
Yeah.
And that's what we're seeing.
Yeah, big time. So with the importance of edge computing for retailers, right? Like you said, the edge is really where customers are first interacting with the retail brand, right? All those digital touch points. So if you were to list it off and speak to it, what do you think a retailer needs to have in place in order for this edge computing to be successful?
Right, so that's a really good question. And I think you need to have a digital platform that will allow you to actually grow and build out those experiences, and so you can scale that, because there's going to be even more data, because as the touch points increase, there's going to be more data.
Yep.
And you see that there's a great big value that you need to extract at the edge, right there, right then, because retail is about here and now. So the experience is about the here and now. It's not waiting for things to happen. So driving forward, looking in the mirror, sometimes it's just not good enough. So you have to make those decisions here and now. And so that's what we're finding. And I think that balance is something that retailers ought to be aware of now.
So how would you say that legacy systems kind of plays into this? Because I know it's a hurdle for a lot of retailers when they're trying to optimize their network and do all the edge computing that they want to have happen. So how does that play
in? So that's a really great question, because traditionally what we've seen is that retailers, I mean, they go after solving issues in a siloed or fenced off fashion, because it's owned by different people in the business, and so they all want to solve their own individual problems. And that's also from a scalability point of view, that's going to be tricky. And then, you know, there's no convergence of applications, and that conversion's missing. Actually, you miss out on a lot of value. You miss out on the ability to actually create a lot of additional experience, things you didn't think about right now. So that's really important, I think. So yeah, great question.
Awesome.
We talk about getting to know your customer, which makes sense. How are you going to best assist shoppers without knowing their preferences and behaviors? But this data and knowledge gathering is only part of the story. delivering that data on an intelligent network to your associates so that they can best engage with visitors not only improves the customer experience and brand loyalty, but to my knowledge, saves the retailer money from an IT operations standpoint as well. Let's see if we can hear a little more about how local compute and the agility of a cloud multi-cloud environment can support more than just customer experiences.
So if we're looking specifically at all the possibilities with edge computing, you touched on customer experience being like a huge benefit. So what are some of the specific examples of customer experiences that you have seen or that you can see becoming possible with proper, scalable, and operational edge computing happening?
So a couple of things that we've seen that I think are really important. We've seen, for instance, the ratio of shoppers being able to serve customers, so that ratio between customer servants and shoppers, that needs to be right, because when you exceed a certain level, you know, when you pull happy or not data, you see that there's really like a cliff where that drops off. And if you do this in a margin rich environment, right, where there's lots of service, you really need to get that right. So the ability to measure that ratio between staff and shoppers, that's something that we can measure, and we can actually then immediately notify people right there, right then. We can actually even have predictors, and we can see that challenge, you know, coming. So we can solve that. So that's I think a great example of where you need to have that edge capacity. So yeah, new digital capabilities, and that's one of them.
That's big. And you touched also on it benefits the retailers, right? Mm-hmm. So if you have all of this edge computing put in place to make that data processed in real time, it helps on the retailer's side too.
100%. Yeah. 100%. And so one of the key things I believe that's really important is for people to understand that once you have that platform in place, you'll be able to answer questions that you didn't know you needed asking. And that's what we're finding. And so that's where the real value becomes available. Right. And that's where you can start to solve some of the things that are the customer complaint or the friction complaint, you know, top 10, and you can start to address some of those issues. So that's whether that's queues, whether that's out of stocks, whether that's the appropriate layout of your store.
Right.
That's really important that you get that right, and that platform will help you.
Right.
And that's what we offer.
That's what we offer. We're seeing the mobile experience is so big from the shopper's perspective, right?
Indeed.
So much of retail is still happening in brick and mortar, and the mobile experience is just elevating how that shopping experience manifests itself, right?
100%. So. And that's exactly right, and that's exactly why we will not see brick and mortar go away. It'll change. Technology will have definitely the big impact, new capabilities. It's about new purpose. And renewing your purpose is a really important struggle for a lot of retailers right now.
Oh yeah.
This is the why are we here and what's our role in the life of a customer. So yeah, the most beautiful thing is that the most things are still left to be done, and so it's a bright future.
It's a lot of opportunity.
Absolutely, 100%.
The future is bright.
We're also seeing a change in the way that shoppers are coming to market, right? There's the in-store that we talked about. There's also BOPIS. There's also just different ways that customers want to interact with the brand. So edge computing, it helps a lot in the in-store, but it is available and beneficial for all these other markets as well, right?
Indeed, indeed. So like I was just saying, I mean, the technology is starting to really change how people interact with your brand. It's changing what the store experience should look like and what it should be. And so there's a lot of things that are commodity and repetitive. So for BOPIS, I mean, that's a great example. So when people go to your store, wouldn't it be great if you knew that they were coming? Wouldn't it be great if you knew what their experience has been in the past? And wouldn't it be great if you could actually then serve that up to your staff so they could serve people even before they get to the store?
Absolutely, and add a touch of personalization, you know, based on your shopping history. We like to recommend these items, kind of increase that ROI. Every retailer looks for that, right?
100%, yes.
Very cool. So maybe last question for you here, Edward. So you're an expert, you've been in retail a long time, you've interacted with customers. What's something that you think folks in the industry that are really looking at it from IT, customer experience, all those different perspectives, what's something that you think is beneficial that they might not know about?
Oh, that's a great question again, Nikki. So what I would say is first just start analyzing the data that you have. There's so many sensors in your store, and you're probably not even looking at that data right now. So, for example, your wireless data. how many people are really looking at the data that the wireless is generating. And that you can do that being GDPR compliant, you know, being within the rules of compliancy. There's so much, you know, information that you can already extract that's already in the network, that's there and is right for you to grab and it's readily available. So, like I said before, it's going to answer questions you didn't know you needed asking.
All right. Well, thank you so much. This has been awesome.
Pleasure, Nikki. Thanks very much, as always. Thank you very much.
So that was our chat with Edward. Striving to leverage IT so that retailers can achieve their business outcomes, but ultimately so that they can achieve their purpose. It's an exciting time for retail, there's no doubt. So we talked with Edward about owning your data across the supply chain, keeping edge computing in mind as retailers are navigating all their data to a multi-cloud environment, and taking a closer look at the trends in your customer data that might be revealed about their buying behaviors. So hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure that you stay tuned for the next video that's released so you don't miss our next conversation about retail tech. And until then, I am Nikki. Thanks for watching.